noble and sentimental waltzes by Maurice Ravel. The National Orchestra of Lyon was led by Leonard Slatkin. It's just great music, isn't it? With 19 minutes past 3 o'clock, it's Classical NPR.
This is 91.1 KCCM Moorhead, Fargo.
Programming is supported by Wright Funeral Home, serving the Red River Valley families for over 138 years, a team of dedicated professionals committed to serving families with care and compassion. There's more information online at WrightFuneral.com.
Hello, I'm NPR's Stephanie Curtis. Join me for the 14th Annual National Book Awards at Concordia College in Moorhead with fiction winner Sigrid Nunez, author of The Friend, and nonfiction finalist Victoria Johnson, author of American Eden. It's on Thursday, October 3rd, 7:30 p.m. at the Centrum. More information at cord.edu/nationalbook.
A love for classical music doesn't just happen. You need an introduction. Introduce your kids to classical with Classical Kids Corner, Saturdays at 8 a.m. Make your request at classicalnpr.org. Click on Classical Kids Corner.
Thank you.
beautiful, solid ending to the Symphonia for Strings by Antonio Vivaldi. The Academy of Ancient Music, based in London, led by violinist-turned-conductor Andrew Manzi. This is Classical Minnesota Public Radio. Support comes from the History Theater's Gloria a Life, a thought-provoking, educational, inspirational, and surprising play about Gloria Steinem. The all-female cast stars Charity Jones as Gloria Steinem. It opens September 28th. More at historytheater.com. Support also comes from Northrop at the University of Minnesota, presenting the Pittsburgh Ballet Theater with live orchestra, performing a new ballet based on F. Scott Fitzgerald's acclaimed novel, The Great Gatsby. September 28th, northrop.umn.edu. When Mozart, all of 18 years old, chose to write his piano sonata number 5, he chose the key of G major. Christian Schubart, who was a music theorist at the time, wrote, "Everything rustic, everything idyllic, everything lyrical, every gentle and peaceful emotion of the heart is expressed in G major." I think Mozart would have agreed. Here's pianist Ivo Pogorelli. Thank you. Piano Sonata 5 by Mozart, a performance at Classical NPR with pianist Ivo Pogarelli. Coming up on 14 minutes until 4 o'clock, I'm Steve Starek. Happy Wednesday! Did you know that today is the perfect day to become a new member of Classical Minnesota Public Radio? Because today is New Member Day. It is easy to overlook how much Classical NPR is a part of your life, but take a moment to think back over the day. Minnesota Public Radio has been a part of it, hasn't it? Mm-hmm. Make sure Classical NPR continues to be a part of your day by making a financial contribution. And today is the perfect day to join, because if you join today before midnight, you'll be invited to our first ever member mixer at our studios coming up next month. Oh. Become a member today at classicalnpr.org/donate. The fall harvest has been underway since mid-August. This next piece is dedicated to all those who harvest. It's called The Plow That Broke the Plains. It's by Virgil Thompson. Leopold Stokowski leads the Symphony Orchestra of the Air.
Ninja? Thank you.